So in today's video, I'm going to be working on this Australian shepherd's eyes. This is a part one out of however many series, and I'm just doing the eyes. I'm not going any further today. So stick around, and I have everything down in the description, the colors that I'll be using for the eyes. I'm using the Faber-Castell Polychromos set. I'm not using Prismacolor. I hope you enjoy this video. I hope this video helps you. And let's get started. So what I did off camera was go in with my white into areas that I know I want to keep the lightest color possible, where the reflections might be. I also went in with my kneading eraser and just got rid of some of the line work that I put down. I'm going to put a copy of my line work down for you guys in the description below. So that way, if you do decide to try drawing this cute little Australian shepherd puppy, you can use it if you want. I found the photo that you see right here somewhere. I just googled royalty free images Australian shepherd, so I found it just in like a Google image search. I'm sure you can get it off of like a, it's like iStock or something like that, I believe. I can't quite remember. But yeah, this is what I will be drawing today. So I did a little bit off camera with my cold gray too. I will try and remember to add in editing the colors that I'm using on the screen for you guys, just so you know. And if I don't say it while I'm using it, then it will be there for your information. So what I did is I just lightly went in with cold gray too, just down here. I'm not using a very hard pressure at this point. I just really want to map in the dark areas. I usually go in straight away with sepia, but I decided not to do that this time around. This is my second attempt at doing this, and I found that going in right away with sepia just didn't help me like it normally does, so I decided to try doing it another way that I know how to do it, which is go in with not a very dark gray, but one of the lighter grays. And since these eyes are on the bluer side, I thought that cold gray too would be the better option. I like printing off my reference photos, so I have it next to me down here. You can kind of see it a little bit, just to rest my hand on, and that way it's kind of easier for me to just look at it every once in a while when I need to, just to remind myself where color should be placed down. So yeah, I hope you enjoy this real-time video. I've done some in the past, but nothing like this. I just actually created a video of drawing husky eyes in real time, so I'm hoping, I updated my OBS, so I'm hoping it doesn't mess up on me like it did for that video. That video I had to use my my cell phone, which turned out alright, can't complain, to capture everything. So it looks a little funny, but you gotta learn from your mistakes. mistakes. So again, I'm just going in nice, light pressure, just back and forth motion. Bring it down here a bit. And right there too. Alright, where else? I'll go here. Now for the pupil part, I'm going in like a small circular motion. This area, I can see in the puppy's reflection that it's more of a line stroke, not circular stroke. So, yeah, down here as well, kind of. Just bring it up. To the side of me. So sorry if you can hear that. So going in with cold gray one, I am going to just put this down very, very lightly. I'm not pushing very hard in small circular motions. Rotating my pencil every once in a while. Jumping back and forth between the eyes, just so that way I'm using, like, I don't have to remember, well, like, what layer did I put down first for that eye, and it's just easier for me to stay on track, so to speak. Alrighty. I'm going to go in with light cobalt next. Okay, so for this color, I'm just going in the darker areas of the eye. I don't really want it in the reflections at all. So like around the pupil, I know would be good. Kind of going in the direction of the eye. I know I want it a little bit here. Just kind of bring it up a bit. I'm using line motions for this. I'm kind of just layering it on top of the cold gray two, really, down around the eye, and this helps give it like more of a realistic look, 3D look, makes the eye like really pop out. I like starting with the eyes. It kind of gives more personality to the eyes, and I really, really try and get the eyes as correct as I can, because then that means this drawing will turn out somewhat decent, I think. If I mess up on the eyes, then I usually restart, like I said last time, like earlier, not last time, earlier in the video, that this is my second attempt. Didn't like how the eyes turned out on the first attempt, so practice makes perfect, I like to say, so yeah. And they kind of look funny right now, but you gotta push through it. You gotta push past the funniness. And again, with this eye, going slightly into the pupil. Gonna bring it up. And okay, and down here too. What's nice about putting a white layer down first, it actually stays relatively white when you put color on top of it. Alrighty. Right here as well. I'm thinking right now if I should put a little bit of purple. Maybe a little bit of purple will help. I'm going to go with manganese, if that's how you pronounce it, violet. Again, I'm really, really not going to go in with hard touch. Kind of a purple. Okay, where else can I put it? I'm gonna put it down over here a bit. And down here. I'm not putting a lot of this color in the eye. Just there for now, I believe. Yeah, we'll leave it like that for now. Okay. Light blue, light. Phthalo blue, if that's how you pronounce it. Again, I'll put it up on the screen for you guys. Move this down a little bit. Okay. Using line motion to put this color down. I'm actually bringing this color into the reflection area a bit. Going over the white with this color. One's pretty. pretty loud outside. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Sorry if you can. Again, rotating my pencil every once in a while. Again, going back and forth between the eyes using the same color. I'm holding my pencil right now closer to the tip, so I have more control over it. Trying to get as much detail as I can added into this little puppy's eye. Alright. Okay. Middle blue. We'll just call him middle blue. Let's start with this eye. Now with this color, I'm definitely going to just put it in the dark areas, because I want the other areas to kind of stay light, like the color they are right now. So I'm going to bring this around the pupil. Pupil around these reflections that I can see. Let's bring it here too. Give it some designs in the eyes, definitely. Around the edge as well. Darken up the waterline a bit. staring at my hand. Put there in the corner a bit, and definitely around this reflection, like so. And again, in the pupil. Okay. I'm gonna bring out line stroke here. And do that. Bring it up. Okay, going with phthalo blue. Okay, with this blue, I'm definitely gonna take my time and add in as much detail that I think I can see. You definitely can see some blue in the pupil. So I'm bringing this color more into the center of the pupil. This is a little bit darker here. And you should start kind of seeing the layers and the eye take shape at this point. Around the water line, I'm kind of doing back and forth, but also tiny little circles, just to kind of bring it up into the eye a bit. So stop there, and then on this side, we're gonna just there and bring it down. Alrighty, and then kind of want it a little bit here. A little bit here. Okay. Maybe I'll touch a bit. I'm not using a heavy pressure here because I just want like a little bit of it. I don't want a lot. Okay, and sharpening. Sorry for the loud noise. Sharpen this pencil just a bit. Okay, and where I put the purple down, I'm going to definitely put some there. And I'm going to bring it up. I'm going to skip a bit, go to the bottom edge, bring it up and over, and then up here.
in the pupil, around the pupil. And there, like that. Bring it into the pupil very lightly.
Alrighty, I'm gonna just keep going darker. I'm gonna sharpen again, sorry. Alright, so this color, I'm definitely gonna be adding more detail with it. Okay, there, around these guys, definitely. Okay, going to this eye. So, before I go any further, I'm gonna go in with dark sepia. And with dark sepia, sorry for all the noise, trying to get my small eraser over here, my hand eraser. Sharpen up that tip a bit. Okay. So, with dark sepia, this is what I normally start with. I'm going to go in. I'm going to add this in the pupil and just in some areas around the water line. Sorry, I went overboard with my first attempt, and I really, really don't want to go overboard this time around. So I'm praying that it turns out okay. So, light pressure, light pressure. I'm going to remind myself, light pressure, kind of bring it in, going in circular motions, light pressure. There, it kind of comes out here a bit. Okay, where else? I'm gonna bring it down here because there is definitely a dark. I don't know if it's like a reflection or if it's just maybe a freckle in the eye. But just kind of do that. Okay, gonna bring it out here a bit. All right. Okay, so I'm gonna go on the waterline down here, taking my time, small strokes back and forth. looking at my reference photo. There. Touch of it here. And here. And to here. Where else? Kind of do a little bit lightly here into the fur. And we'll actually, yeah, light here. And just kind of do small line motions here into the fur. Alright, I think. I'll actually bring it to the fur there. And then and this eye. Light, small circles right now. Around here. Light. Okay, we're gonna bring it around the reflection a bit. We're going to bring it to this harsh line. Okay, just a touch in this corner. Good. I'm going to turn this kind of sideways. Sorry, you guys. Turning it sideways. And we're going to take it into there. Lightly. Bring it down. Here. Light pressure. I'm reminding myself, light. Don't push too hard, it kind of curves out into there. Bring it down a bit, just slightly, like that. Okay, and we're gonna bring it up there and into the fur. So I'm actually slightly taking sepia and putting it into where the eyelashes would be for the dog. Hands shaking. Okay. Bring it. Okay, let me just, I'm gonna move this eye a bit, sorry. Going around like this. Alright, where am I going for this color? I'm gonna bring it up a bit. A little bit to the corner. Bring it up into the eye a bit. Just kind of do this. Trying to give this eye a little bit more of a round look. So I'm bringing my sepia a little bit more up into the eye. Light pressure again, just to give it more shadows. Where else should it go? It should come down here a tad bit. Light pressure. Okay. I'm gonna darken up here. So darkening up this area, I'm actually going in with a little bit of a harder pressure. Darkening up the pupil just a tad bit. Bring it down like that. Alright, so we got some designs here. I'm going to bring sepia into this area of the eye. Give it a little bit of a design. Same with there. Okay. Where else should it go? I think it should actually... Give some eyelash strokes of it. Okay. All right. Same with this eye, we're going to darken up the pupil by giving slightly harder pressure. Going in big circles and little circles and bringing it out a bit to give some designs. Little squiggly lines in the eye. Alright. Going back to my blues. What blue am I going to use? Persian blue. Okay. Sharpening up my tip off camera. Alright. With this color, let's go here. I don't know. Oh, my head's in the frame. Okay. So I'm just going around the edges of the eyes right now. Going in where I put down sepia. But also around the edges. The lighter areas so I can give more details in the eye. Bring it up here. Just want to add a little bit more details in this puppy's eyes. I'm just concentrating right now. Alright. And this eye, I'm going to actually rotate it a bit so I can get a better angle on it.
Picking up right here a bit. And definitely take this blunt line, just smooth it out, make it make sense. All the dark areas kind of together a little bit. Get the impression of eyeshadows there a little bit. And here. I can erase that later. Okay, so before I go in with my dark indigo, I'm gonna add a little bit of that purple that I brought out at the beginning, the manganese violet. I don't know, I think I just need a little bit more of a purple tone in these eyes and the dark areas of certain spots. Like for this eye, for example, I'm just going to add a bit here. And here. Where else? You know what? I will add it around the water edge as well a bit. Not pushing hard. Add a bit over here as well. Maybe a little bit for a line. Okay. Think that worked. What's great about layering as well is afterwards I can go in with my crafting knife and just lighten up any areas I think I went too dark. So I'm going up here a bit, down there a bit, I'm adding some here definitely. And some in this area. Okay. Maybe a little bit here. Whoops. One on the eye. Rub my hand off. Okay. So. Indigo blue. Dark indigo. Camera, sorry you guys. We have to go deliver a pet portrait today, so it's an alarm because I thought I'd still be sleeping, but here I am drawing. Adding dark indigo into the pupil of the eye. Slightly down here. of mark down light, but I want to add a little bit of a bluer tint to them. Same with this eye. Don't mind my pencil, it's coming into frame. Get over the reflection. And definitely in the pupil. So before I go in with, I don't even know what other colors I could do. What's that? That's more gray. Okay, I'm gonna go in with my exact, not exact, but my crafting knife. Because I've gone a little bit too dark here. Lightly scraping away some of these colors. Alrighty. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is actually gonna go back with that light blue a bit. Blend along the colors in together.
this eye too. Cold gray one again. Blend out a few areas. Not blend out, but like blend together. Gonna go in with white just in some spots and lighten up anything that needs to be lightened. Alright. So I'm risking it and going in with black now. I'm using a slightly heavier touch. But I'm actually not going all the way around the pupil. I'm just kind of going in like a C shape because this area is actually like a lot lighter. Okay, so this waterline down here, just a little bit thicker. So instead of going into the eye, I'm going to bring it out towards the fur. Just rotating the picture, rotating the drawing, sorry, as I'm doing this. This part isn't that dark. I might have to lighten it up a little bit maybe afterwards, but definitely here is dark. So I'm using the tip of my pencil. Going around the outer edge like so. Looking. And I kind of want to again, the bottom water edge is slightly thicker, so I'm bringing it down. Darker, so I'm using a heavier touch. Okay, so the pupil now. Pupil. Yeah, this one can kind of go all the way around, but not really much in the center of the eye. I don't want it in the center. Where else? Okay. Bring it down and around here. And I'm rotating the drawing as I'm working on it. And it doesn't go all the way down. So. Alright, that's how I'm going to do it, I think. Make this a little bit more round. Yeah. Just touch this one up a bit, bring it. Try and lighten this corner just a tad bit. Okay. And up here a bit too, I'm gonna lighten up this line. I think I'm going to leave the eyes for now. Gotten at a point where I'm okay with them. Maybe do some touch-ups off camera. But yeah, I think this is good for now. Got a little purple here.
the eyes there for now. I'm going to go in with beige red into this area here. Blend this color a little bit into the eye edge. Same with over here. Bit of purple again. Just kind of bring that purple here. Same with over here. And just give me a touch of blue in these parts as well. Light blue. There's a slight hint of blue. This part of the eye. Okay. Looking a little funny. Maybe a little bit darker than the reference photo, but that's alright. So I'm gonna end part one here for now, I believe. Yeah, I'm gonna end part one here. So, thank you for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like the video, leave a comment down below, and if you haven't done so already, subscribe. I'm gonna be putting out more videos to this Australian Shepherd. So stick around and wait for those to come out. Yeah. Alright, see you in the next video, you guys.